Hi there. Today we're going to have a look at one of the most confusing things when it comes to smart homes, communication protocols. So let's have a look. So if I was designing a brand new home today and I could have my ultimate smart home, I would try and do away with any wireless protocols at all to avoid any issues. I would go with a completely wired system and it would be amazing. Now, of course, most of us live in existing homes with little or no pre-wiring for smart home devices, so we're limited to using wireless protocols. So let's have a look at these different protocols. First one naturally that would come to mind would be Wi-Fi. And of course, these are ubiquitous. These sort of devices are available everywhere now. So some of the good things about Wi-Fi are, first of all, you don't need to buy a new hub because the Wi-Fi router that you've got is already in place. Second of all, there are all types of devices. So you can have high bandwidth devices like cameras and all sorts of other devices that can operate off Wi-Fi. Another good thing about it is that they are pretty cheap because they are available everywhere and there's lots of different options available. The response times can be reasonably good as well. However, this is dependent on cloud connection. Now, some of the challenges that we have with Wi-Fi. The first major thing is that if you're using a cheap router that came from your provider, you'll find that most of them are limited to 30 devices. And even though that might sound a lot in the beginning, you'll quickly see that when you add up all the televisions, laptops, iPhones, etc. in your house, that there's very little space before you reach that limit. The second thing is a lot of the Wi-Fi devices are cloud-based. Now, of course, cloud-based means that we are restricted by what the manufacturer is doing with the cloud. If they decide to turn that cloud off, our device is basically useless. Secondly, we are also limited by changes that they make. So we might set up an integration with a cloud-based device and the next minute it is not working anymore because the supplier has changed things. Next up we have Zigbee. Now this one has become hugely popular and the reason for this is that the devices can be really nice and small. They can run on coin cells because they are low power consumption. They run locally, so we're not reliant on a cloud connection. They have this mesh system, so wherever you've got powered devices, these are able to route on the signal to the next device, which means that they can operate over large distances. Some of the issues though with Zigbee is, first of all, they can't stream high data, so things like cameras can't run off Zigbee, and also they do require another hub in order to connect with the Zigbee radio signal. Now, with hubs, there is also the issue that some manufacturers don't always talk to some hubs. So we have the issue of sometimes having to have multiple hubs in this network. Z-Wave is a protocol that has been around for a long time now. Some of the good things about Z-Wave, first of all, it offers you a long range communication. It also is working on a mesh dependency, so one device is bouncing off the next to extend the signal. Provided you're using a Z-Wave that is designed for a specific country, they will be able to all communicate with each other. And less interference as the frequency of the radio waves is lower. Some of the not so good things about Z-Wave, first of all, a limited number of devices available, types of devices. They're always quite expensive because they have to pay a fee to the Z-Wave network. And there is another thing, which is that the Z-Wave is a different frequency in different countries. So you do need to be careful. Make sure that you're ordering the correct frequency for your country. Matter is something relatively new to smart homes. Now, Matter is a connection standard rather than a communication type or protocol. Matter is designed to allow IoT devices to connect to different smart home platforms and to work cross-platform. So the idea of Matter is effectively that any Matter device can speak to any smart home hub, which is amazing. Now, these are slowly coming along. I've tested some really good Matter devices recently that connect really easily and work amazingly well and don't disconnect at all. However, I've also had some issues. I've ordered some Matter devices that have not connected at all. So it is a development program still for Matter. It's experimental in a lot of the cases. So we're waiting to see how that's going to fulfill itself. Also, it doesn't allow for all things. For example, you can't connect cameras over Matter yet. And also, things like a smart plug might, for example, allow you to turn it on and off with a Matter connection, but not allow you to see the power usage on that specific smart plug. Now, when you talk about Matter, there are two actual communication protocols that can rely on a Matter connection. The first one is Wi-Fi. So Matter connects the devices and then it's a Wi-Fi connection, which is then local. The second one is the Thread system. So Thread is in a lot of ways very similar to Zigbee. It can even often operate on the same radio as a Zigbee, where it can bounce between the two different protocols. So it offers the benefits of having low power, so battery powered devices, and also a mesh network. One of the main limitations of Thread at the moment, it is still experimental, so often it may not work. Secondly, the Thread devices themselves are pretty expensive right now. Some other protocols are Bluetooth. So Bluetooth is once again very low power, but very short distance. So only up to 10 meters at an absolute maximum. So that means that you need to have a Bluetooth proxy device, for example, in each room where you're going to use it. Lora Wan is a protocol that a lot of people haven't heard of. This is something that can be used over really, really long distances. You can even have multiple kilometers away connection to devices. So really useful for long distance, but very low bandwidth. 433 megahertz is a protocol that was used a long time ago. These devices are still around and you still can connect to them using a hub. They're also super, super cheap. So worth trying out. Well, that's all for now. I hope you've enjoyed this video and let me know what you think in the comments below about what your favorite protocol is. And if you've enjoyed this content, please like and subscribe, and I'll look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye for now.